Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys all about constructors in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. You too can become a hero and save our channel by punching the like button, throw a comment down below, and smash the subscribe button. Alright guys and gals, in this video I'm going to be explaining constructors to you all. Now a constructor is a special method that is called when an object is instantiated, and when we instantiate something, that's just a fancy term for creating an object. Now for this example, I have two classes. I have my main class that contains my main method, and I also have another class within my project folder called human. We're going to be creating some human objects today. Now, normally the steps of creating an object, we would type in the name of the class, for this example it's human, a unique name for this specific object, we'll just call this human, all lowercase, equals new human. Now this portion works very similar to a standard method call, except a constructor is a special method that works behind the scenes that will create an instance of a class for us. It will instantiate an object. Basically speaking, our constructor is acting as a special method, and we can even pass in arguments when we instantiate it. So if we would like to do something with these arguments, like assign them to the attributes of our object, we can set up the constructor within the class. So this is how to create the constructor within our class. It's going to have the same name as the class. For this example, it's human, followed by a set of parentheses and then a set of curly braces. And that's it, we have our constructor. So when we create an instance of this class, it's going to call the constructor much like a method, and anything within the constructor will be performed just like a standard method. So we can actually set up some parameters and pass in some arguments when we create our object. So let's set up some parameters for our human class. What are a few attributes that a human might have? For one, a name, like Bob or something. So let's define the first parameter of string name, perhaps an age, int age, and then a weight, int, actually let's make this a double, double weight. So we have now set up three parameters for this human class. Let's head back to our main class. Now we're going to have a problem. That's because we do not have matching arguments to send our human. That's because we're saying that in order to construct a human, these are the parameters, these are the rules. In order for us to instantiate a human, to create a human object, we need to send our constructor a string, an integer, and a double value to serve as the name, the age, and the weight. So in order to get this program working, within the constructor, we need to pass in some matching arguments. So we need to send a string, an integer, and a double value. So let's call our human Rick, and we'll pass in Rick for the first argument. Let's send an age, perhaps 65, so he's elderly, and then a weight. Perhaps this will be in kilograms. So let's say maybe 70. See, now that error went away, so we can compile and run this, but it currently doesn't do anything. So why is this useful? Why is passing arguments to a constructor useful? Well, this gives us the ability to create different objects that have different attributes. So we could create a second human that has a different name, a different age, and a different weight. But we first need to assign these values to the attributes of our class. So let's head back to our human class, and we need to define a name, an age, and a weight. And let's do this outside of the constructor, but we're not going to assign a value just yet. So let's say string name, we're only going to declare this, int age, and double weight. And then within the constructor, we're going to assign all of these values to each of these variables. So right now, let's say name equals name, and age equals age, and weight equals weight. Now, this actually isn't going to work, and I'll show you why. So let's attempt to access human1's name, and let's do this with a println statement. System.out.println, to access one of these attributes, we type in the name of the object, dot, and whatever we're trying to access. Let's attempt to access the name. Now, if we were to display the name, it says null. Well, what gives? That's because we need to assign each of these values to this specific object, and one keyword to assign values to this object is to use the this keyword. So when we assign name equals name, age equals age, and weight equals weight, we're going to precede each of these with the keyword this. This dot name, this dot age, and this dot weight. So for all intents and purposes, when we create an instance of a class, when we create an object, we're going to imagine or pretend that we're replacing this keyword with the name of the object. So if we're creating an object called human, replace this or pretend that we're replacing this with human. If we created a second human object, this could be human too. Just pretend that, but stick with the keyword of this. So now if we were to run this, human now has a name. Now let's create a second human. So let's repeat the steps. Human, I'm going to call this human2 and rename human as human1 just to keep things simple. Now we can send different arguments to our constructor. So we need to send a name, an age, and a weight. Well, a string, an integer, and a double. So for our second human, let's call him Morty. We need to send an integer. Let's say he's 16 and he weighs 50 kilograms. And let's attempt to access human2's name. So we can do this within a print line statement, human2.name. And this should display Morty. So now the point of constructors is that they allow us to construct objects that have varying attributes. And in the last lesson, when we were constructing cars, we were only able to construct blue Corvettes. And with the help of constructors, we can construct objects that have different qualities. So they are still humans, they're objects that are instantiated from the human class, but they have different attributes that make them unique. Here's one situation that you might run into. Now, how can you access an object's attributes from within its class itself? So we can utilize this keyword to help us with that. So let's pretend that humans have two methods. They have an eat method as well as a drink method. And let's define these both. So for eat, let's say void eat. And within this method, let's create a print line statement that says, this person's name is eating. So in order to access an object's attributes from within its own class, we have to use this keyword. So if we want to display the person's name plus maybe some text such as is eating, let's type in this.name to access this object's name plus is eating. So this will print the person's name plus is eating. And let's try this. So let's say human2, which is Morty, is eating. So in order to call this method, we'll have human2 use its eat method. So this will display Morty is eating. Now let's create a drink method, void drink, and we will display this person's name is drinking. System.out.println, this.name plus is drinking. Burp. And let's say human1, which is Rick, is going to use the drink function because he likes drinking. So human1 dot drink. And here are the results. Morty is eating and Rick is drinking. That's because we stated that human2 is going to use its eat method and human1 is going to use its drink method. So if we had each of these objects perform the other method, a different method, let's say human1 is going to use the eat method and human2 is going to use its drink method. So now each of these objects is using a different method. This time Rick is eating and Morty is drinking. So that's why constructors are useful. They allow us to assign different attributes to each object that we instantiate. So that's the basics of constructors. If you would like a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of constructors in Java.
Hey, you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.